Hi there guys, it's Greg from Beastie Geeks, and in this video I want to show you Dice Throne Adventures. It's an expansion to the Dice Throne series, and it's a little bit different than the first and second season of the game, because Adventures introduces co-op modes that you can play together and fight with the bosses and explore the map. So let's check out what we can find inside of the Adventures gigantic box, and also we will tell you just a few words or a few sentences about basic Dice Throne if you do not know this game, so we will introduce it in this video also. So let's start.
We really enjoyed the re-rolled version of Dice Throne Season 1. We get 8 very different, very asymmetric characters, each with their own set of skills on the players' boards and unique deck of cards. From very straightforward barbarian smashing opponents with his axe to a shadow thief, debuffing enemies with statuses and damaging them over time with poison. The gameplay is fast, often quite tight, and definitely super exciting and engaging. And components execution is flawless. Graphic arts are stunning, components quality is very high, and each hero has even its own tray, so the whole setup is just opening the box and picking up the hero. Dice Throne Season 1 Re-rolled is probably one of the best one-on-one competitive games with dice, but those dice mean some flaws too. If you are going to push your luck too much, or you don't have it at all, you can end with a turn when you don't perform any actions at all, watching how your opponent, who has better luck, crushes you. Maybe it's not a very common situation and you get many ways to prevent it from happening, but it still occurs and helplessness is the worst. Some extra mechanics like saving your dice roll for the next turn would be awesome. But besides that, Dice Throne Season 1 Re-rolled is a very strong game which gets from us an easy 8 on 10 scratches. And then we have Adventures. I know that many of us demand from publishers co-op and solo modes for our favorite titles, but some of the best competitive games shouldn't be translated into a co-op. And from our perspective, this can be a case with Adventures too. But let's start with the pro. The first impression was very nice. Adventures is a very massive box with an awesome cover and even more awesome content inside. A decent amount of cards with the new art design, hero standees, a lot of map tiles, bosses boards as grand as players, more dice, plenty of tokens, and of course great starter system, only highlighting how well thought all of it is. Nothing less we can expect from the people behind Season 1 Re-rolled. And then we start the game. The flow of it is divided into two stages: exploring the map and fighting the boss. Repeat this cycle until you beat the final game's boss, the Mad King. The problem is the exploration of the map requires a lot of grinding, doing over and over the same stuff, which is mostly moving one tile, killing the minion and repeating this till you move on a tile with the final portal shard needed to unlock the final tile of a scenario. It still could be interesting, but stuff written on tiles you explore is quite repetitive and doesn't matter that much to the gameplay. The main role of the tiles is to determine the difficulty of a minion you have to face. Fighting minions is okay at the beginning and quite similar to what we know from Season 1. When it comes to enemies, every opponent has its own static goal that they want to roll on their dice. So you will reroll dice twice for them to get as many matches with the goal as possible. Repeating that over and over gets quite boring, and different types of minions don't diminish this feel. When exploring the map lacks a bit of engagement and excitement, facing bosses is much better and serves most of the stuff we loved in competitive Dice Throne. But instead of fighting with each other, we fight against the AI enemy with its own board and deck. To resolve which action the enemy should launch, you have to go through most of the skills on his board to match the dice results. It's quite messy, but it serves the purpose. encounters can be challenging because bosses are formidable enemies with a nice diverse skill set. But on the other hand, even those fights can become repetitive. For example, Fallen Barbarian heals himself almost every turn, so beating him up takes eons. And when your HP is dangerously low during this fight, you are going to use self tokens to replenish your health. He's healing, you are healing, and you are playing cat and mouse until Fallen Barbarian will be dead. I believe it will be more engaging to limit Fallen healing abilities and deny your party use self tokens at the same time. Battle will be more deadly, shorter, and less repetitive. Dice Throne Adventures is purely about fighting the enemies, and it doesn't pretend to serve you any serious story. Besides a small intro about the Mad King, we do not get anything to make it more immersive. The game also lacks any extra flavor text. Locations on tiles are quite generic, and even bosses are less creative than we could expect. Fallen Barbarian, Fallen Monk, Fallen Gunslinger, plus Mad King, and that's all. It's hard to imagine playing this game with more than two people at the table, unless you are super patient or you expect not that much engaging session when you can gossip with friends and dig your phone a lot. And the reason for that is a long downtime between players' rounds, where you don't have almost any interaction between players and literally nothing to do besides waiting for your turn. Turn during which is possible you are going to do exactly the same things as before, or even nothing in case of the super bad dice roll, so the feeling of waiting and doing not much is even bigger. Naturally, the campaign introduced a development system for our heroes. For killing the enemies, you get not only healing and gold, but also extra cards for your deck, split into common, rare, and epic ones. When you get a new card, you simply replace the weaker one with a new one. The problem is the new cards are a bit disappointing. Most of them do exactly the same things, but are cheaper to buy, and that's all. When we hear that any game offers character development, we expect something more exciting. Here, upgraded versions of the cards are simply cheaper to buy, nothing more. Of course, when you will gather a lot of cards with the lowered usage costs, it's possible for you to play more cards in one turn and launch even a combo, but it's still quite underwhelming. We expected new breathtaking skills, not lowering the costs of usage. This way, hunting epic cards, collecting gold, trading with the merchant, all of it seems quite pointless. The only stuff that really matters and raises your chances of finishing the scenarios successfully are self tokens, which you can use to heal yourself. Forcing yourself through the whole campaign could be still worth the effort because of the rewards you get by killing the final boss. Rewards which depend on how successful you were through the game. I do not want to spoil any surprises, but the final reward is something really cool, and if you are not planning to finish the campaign, I highly recommend opening the legacy deck of cards. Time for the summary. We can imagine that some of you will have the best time with Dice Throne Adventures. Fighting bosses is fun and stays true to the original competitive game, so liked by the community. And if you don't mind a ton of grinding with quite repetitive map exploration and not the best heroes development system, you can actually enjoy the game a lot. But for us, those flaws disqualifies the cooperative approach a lot. So our final score is 5.5 on 10 scratches possible. That's all for today. See you in the next game. And if you enjoy our content and honest approach to the games, subscribe to our channel and join us on Patreon.